In the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, our friends at Discover Newport have brought us Fathoms at the Newport Marriott. Chef Eric Steinhauer, but Sam Adams, Braised Short Ribs. You promised me last week when you were here that you would bring me meat.
There it is.
You are a man who delivers.
I went out and found a cow. I brought him home. I took care of him.
That's
the result.
That's why I love you.
And then, I mean, you can't have beef without beer, and Sam Adams was more than
perfect.
Lucky to give us a couple beers. So,
good stuff. All right, you got a lot of things going on here.
Sure.
Let's go over some of the ingredients.
Sure, okay. Well, obviously, the most important thing is we have the short ribs here. You want to make sure if you buy the short ribs at the store, you cut off a little bit of the excess fat.
Mm-hmm.
You have garlic, shallots, tomato. A little bit of mirepoix, which is just carrots, onions, and celery. That's going to make your stock. You have tomato product. You have some nice fresh herbs here. You got some thyme and some rosemary. And that's pretty much it for the ribs with the sauce here. And then you're going to have a side dish of a polenta, some braised Swiss chard, and you got an onion jam going on here. So there's a whole lot of things going on in your dish today.
Is there a chef secret that you can share with everybody out there when we're looking for ribs? Because ribs can be hit or miss sometimes. Sometimes when you get them, they can, no matter how good they look,
right,
they still can be tough.
What you want to make sure, well, the to make them not tough is the amount of time that you cook it. It's
okay.
Slow and long.
Right.
Okay, so 300 degrees, about 2.5-3 hours for something this size. But, you know, when you're looking at the ribs, I haven't touched these yet as far as cutting off, but you have a little bit of the fat here. You have the beautiful marbleization. You got about 2 inches on the bone and about 1.5 inches on the meat. That right there would be perfect, and it won't be too tough. It won't get too dry. It'll be nice and tender. It'll kind of melt in your mouth when you use it with a fork.
And you do want to see some marbleization through it because that's the flavor of it.
Absolutely.
Right?
Fat equals flavor. That's what I tell my wife. So.
And we know all about that. Yes, we do.
We do.
All right. We've got the ingredients ready to go. I'm a very happy man today. We're going to cook this up. Back to you.
All right, thank you, Meg. Chef Eric gave me these, and I don't know what I'm doing with them.
Don't hurt yourself with those now.
Okay, I know we're making beer braised short ribs.
Absolutely.
What are we doing now?
All right, well,
now?
We've gone ahead and seared off the beef, so we're good with that. So
okay.
Now what we're going to be doing is getting everything ready to put in the oven.
Ooh,
so we want to start off with a little bit of garlic and shallots. We'll get you a little mirepoix, which is just some carrots, onion, and celery. You want to go ahead and stir that around a little bit?
Okay.
So all we're doing here is we're just trying to saute that off to help bring out the flavor.
Do you have any oil or anything else in there?
There's a tad bit of oil left in from the beef. As you can see, all that lovely stuff on the bottom is called fond. That's where all the flavor is. As we were talking in the earlier section, fat, that's where it is right there.
A little bit fat. Fat is flavor,
yeah.
Right?
Fat is flavor, and you know, a little everything in moderation. So we have some fresh herbs here. We got some rosemary, some thyme.
Yum.
Throw that in there. And then tomato, a little bit of tomato.
This is great. And this is all, too, in preparation of Newport Restaurant
Week. Absolutely. This started last Friday. We have Restaurant Week going through this Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
It was a great weekend. It's a gorgeous weekend. A lot of people came out.
For more people, of course.
Absolutely. Well, you know, if
you
it's going to rain
at night,
absolutely. If it's going to rain during the week, you know, come on and get out of the rain. Come in, have yourself a nice lager, have yourself some nice beef. We got some fish stew. You can see all the menus on Discover Newport. RestaurantWeek.org.
Mm-hmm.
They can see who's doing lunch, who's doing dinners. All right, we got that going there.
Beautiful.
And the next thing you want to do is throw in, well, let's do our lager here. Get them on there.
Woo! Would you suggest using a beer that you would drink?
Absolutely.
Just for the flavor?
You want a little bit heavier beer, you know, a little bit more body, a little bit more flavor. Obviously, this lager is really good, but you can do any one that you want.
Okay.
Go ahead and throw that in there. You want to throw your stock in.
Great. All right. We're going to get this going, and you will see us finish this whole dish. Talk a little bit more about Restaurant Week 2 coming up a little later in the show. Back to you.
Excellent.
I love our friends from Discover Newport today. They brought a chef, Eric. Fathoms at Newport. Marriott is the place. We've got some braised short ribs.
Absolutely.
Adam's braised short ribs.
Absolutely.
Good to go.
So we've got the short ribs in the oven, mm-hmm. which Michaela did a little while ago. We got her plenty.
She didn't eat any, did she?
Not yet. She's
no.
getting ready
they
to, though.
They weren't cooked yet.
Yeah.
I couldn't do that. How long are they going in the oven?
They're
going
to be in the oven for about 1.5 hours, 2 hours. The longer it goes, obviously, the better it is.
Okay.
For those of you that like to do crock pot cooking, that's a great crock pot
dish.
I do
love crock pot cooking.
Throw it all in the crock pot before you go to work. Set it on low. 8 hours later, come home. It's good to go.
Okay.
Perfect.
So low in the crock pot, but what's the temperature on
about
the oven?
About 300, 350 degrees in your oven right here.
Perfect.
It depends on how much time you have. Me personally, I like throwing it in the crock pot and just forgetting about it.
Right. Yeah. Right.
At work, obviously, I have to do it this way. So we have that going in there. We have the onion jams already ready to go. The polenta's ready to go. So now we need to do our Swiss chard.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is put a little bit of olive oil inside.
All right.
A little bit of garlic. A little bit of onion.
Yum.
Now, Swiss chard, I'm from the South, so we love greens down there.
Right.
So that's just why we do the Swiss chard. It's very healthy for you. A lot of people like spinach, kale. Mm-hmm. Swiss chard just has a little bit more of a bitterness flavor to it. Yeah.
And does it hold together better when it's cooked?
Absolutely. That's well, just everything that you put with a little bit of fat and garlic is going to taste better.
Sure.
You eat that like you would a salad? Will, may I try a piece of that? Because you said what, spinach and kale, but this has a little bit more.
Yeah, it's a little more bitter.
So can you eat it just like this?
You can. Yeah. I mean, my wife likes eating greens, raw like that.
Ooh, I like it.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's a good green. It kind of gets lost in the mix there with all the rest of the more famous ones, but
I feel like it's like sweetened spinach.
Yes, exactly. So a little bit of salt and pepper.
Yum.
Put it in there. Saute this off again. You don't want to kill it. It's real quick.
What do you mean by kill it?
Well, I'm doing a high heat right now, but if you were doing it at home, you'd probably do a little bit slower of a heat.
Okay.
That way, what happens is it still has its integrity and it doesn't just wilt and shrink up
part
of immediately. And then just a little bit of balsamic vinegar.
Yeah.
So you're kind of making a
so there's a lot of flavors going on there.
Oh, absolutely. And with going with those ribs, it's going to come out good for you. All right, so there we have that. So we already have a plate going here for you.
Wow. All right.
So we'll go ahead and
finish
that.
Already have polenta on there?
Yeah, we have the polenta, which is just cornmeal, a little bit of stock, salt and pepper, butter, cheese.
Right.
Very, very simple.
Got it.
And when you're making polenta, is that something that you should be constantly stirring?
No, bring it to a boil, throw in the cornmeal. It's almost going to be an instantaneous type of thing.
Okay.
And go ahead.
Oh, my God, this looks so great. I just passed out.
Well, can I just say, too, Chip, you just went to pick one of them up, and the bone just came out.
Yeah, it is definitely.
When you know it's
yeah, absolutely. So we have that there.
Here, Will,
sorry
I'm not even going to.
It's behind you. And then we have the onion jam, which we're going to put on top of there.
Wow.
So, knock yourself out, sir. That cow went for you.
I'm taking it this way. Come on, follow me.
Here we go. Follow me.
And Chef,
I'm taking it over here.
While Will just indulges
absolutely.
In every single bite. Go ahead, buddy. Tell us a little bit more about Restaurant Week. What are the deals? What are we talking here?
Well, you have a three-course meal. Mm-hmm. You have lunch, which goes for $15, and then you have dinner, which goes for $30. Like I said, all the menus are available on Discover Newport, restaurantweek.org, which is like this. And I mean, a lot of people wouldn't come down to Newport, to try some of the different restaurants because they think it's either too expensive or this or that.
Yeah.
So this is a great opportunity to come down and try it, see what you like.
Yeah.
That way you come back in the wintertime, in the summertime. It's not just seafood. It's not just chowder. I mean, it's obviously
everything.
It's all
and this
kinds
is on
things.
The menu?
Absolutely. This is our number one
Will?
Seller right now.
I'm bellying up
that?
To the bar.
All right. Will is going to enjoy that a little bit more. Chef, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
You made him a happy guy. He's not even looking at you. He's just staring down at the plate the whole
you're
time.
You're welcome. You're most welcome.
If you want this recipe so you can make it at home, head on over to WPRI.com.